Hello, and welcome back to The Efficient Skillet. My name is Willie, and I hope that you're doing extremely well out there. I know that I am. I finally got me a good MAGA hat. This one right here is much better. The Make America Great Again logo stands out way. It stands way up front, way better than the cheapy other ones I had. The first one I got, I won at a Christmas party at my cousin's house in Houston, in one of those fun games where people keep switching gifts. And it's, you know, apologies to whoever got this at my cousin's party. This one's cheap. It caves in right there. That's not going to cut it. Then I got this one off eBay, and it's a little better, but it's still kind of rednecky looking and caves in. But if you want one that, like, the man, the myth, the legend, President Trump wears, you got to spend a few extra bucks. And so I got this one, and it was expensive, not like $100 or anything, but about half of that. But it's a much better hat, and I'm very pleased with it. I'm just tickled pink. Today we're going to do something really, really good, lasagna roll-ups. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is get some water boiling. I'm going to put a couple of pinches of salt in this water. And then we're going to use lasagna, of course. Now, this is not oven-ready lasagna. This is old school, the kind you have to boil it and then take it out and use it. This is what we want. So you can get this at Walmart or HEB. So you take 10 of these, 10 of the lasagna noodles, and you just put them in your water, however you do it. And just for the fun of it, I'm gonna put this lid on. And you cook them till they're completely cooked. Okay, once your lasagna is fully cooked, what works for me is I pull them out and then I'll just lay it down. And with each piece of lasagna, I'll take some of this no-stick spray. This is really just olive oil is all it is. And just real quick, just go like that. And then that'll keep them from sticking together because I'm gonna stack them on top of each other for convenience. So I'll lay that one on there and just like that, that's good. Just barely spray it and then just stack them up, all 10 of them. Next thing we're gonna do is take 2 pounds of ground beef. Now I like to use the 96% lean. Okay, so these are 1 pound each. So get them at HEB. So 2 pounds of extra lean ground beef. And we're gonna break up this ground beef nicely. We're also gonna add 2 pinches of salt to this, to our ground beef here. And it's a good idea to put some black pepper in it. However much you choose, you're basically salting and peppering to taste. But you gotta be careful with that salt because the cheese and stuff we add to this has a lot of salt in it. So you don't wanna oversalt something. Remember, if you oversalt something, then it's ruined. You can't fix something that's oversalted. So be careful with the salt. Once your ground beef is fully cooked, what I like to do is just tilt my pan like that. I put my chopping board under there, under one side like that. And then I'll just sort of scoot it all to one side. And then whenever you do, as you can see, the fat and water that comes out of this ground beef drains to that side because, you know, we don't need all that water in our mixture that we're going to put inside our lasagna roll-ups. Anyway, so do that and then get your ground beef out and put it in a bowl. Here we go. Next, we're gonna take a 15 ounce little thing of ricotta cheese. I got tall ones at the store and the short ones. This is obviously the short one. Get the short one of ricotta, and we're just gonna dump the whole thing right into our ground beef. Then we're gonna add one egg. and 1 cup of mozzarella cheese. And of course, we're going to mix it all together. Once you have that mixed in, we're going to add in 1 15-ounce jar of this Alfredo sauce. Now, this is the garlic Alfredo. I think the garlic does really well for this. Anyway, it's a small jar, 15 ounces. We're just going to pour that in there. Okay, what we're going to do now is take some of our mixture here. We got the Alfredo sauce in there, the ricotta and the mozzarella. And we're going to take some of this and we're going to put it on the bottom of this pan. This is a no-stick pan. And we're just going to put some on the bottom here. Just enough to cover the, put a thin coat on the bottom. What we're going to do now is we're going to start rolling these lasagna roll-up things. Just want to spread some out on there. And then you're just going to take it and just start rolling it up like this. Some's going to come out the side. All that's okay. It's to be expected. There we go. And then we're going to take it and place it right in there just like that. Do another one. Once you have them all rolled up and put in your pan, all 10 of them, then the next thing, you have a little bit of this, not a whole lot, but just a little bit of the filling left. You can take it and sort of just put it over each one, sort of spread them out on them a little bit. The next thing we're gonna do is put another jar of that same Alfredo sauce onto our rolled up lasagnas. With our Alfredo sauce all over our lasagna roll-ups here, next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna take some mozzarella, put it on here. Mozzarella cheese is classic Italian cheese, just the name should tell you. Mozzarella, okay? It's good stuff, it's great cheese, it's awesome cheese. My personal favorite cheese of all is sharp cheddar. I love sharp cheddar cheese. But this is Italian, so, and you could put sharp cheddar on here, but I'm gonna keep this Italian. After you put that mozzarella cheese on there, we're gonna really get Italian. We're gonna put Parmesan. Next, I'm gonna take some fresh basil that I got at HEB here in Livingston. And we're gonna dump the whole package out. It's not a whole lot. And we're gonna chop this up nicely. Let me take these fat stems out of there. I don't like fat stems. We're gonna take this basil and we're gonna chop it up nicely and put it all over the top of this. With our oven preheated to 350 degrees, we're just gonna pop this puppy in there. We're gonna leave it in there 20 to 30 minutes. For about the last 5 minutes of the 30 minute oven, 20 to 30 minute thing, for about the last 5 minutes, I'm gonna switch it over to broil, just add some nice browning. Oh man, look at that. Look at that. Wow. All right, let's see what we got here. Let's see what this is all about. We'll take this one lonely one off right off the end right here. Okay, let's cut into this and see what it's all about. Now this stuff's hot, so be careful. Be careful. Oh man. Man. Folks, that is really, really good. Everything in it is just so savory. It's creamy, it's rich, it's tender. It's nice, I use that garlicky Alfredo, so it's nice and garlicky with that really good beef in there. Man, have that with a little red wine. Mamma mia. So anyway, I hope you try it, and I hope you like it. And if you haven't done so, click our subscribe button. And you can email us, efficientskillet@gmail.com. Make America great again.